So set number one. Okay, what is the process that we are going to adopt for any LRDI set? First step is you read well. Okay. Second step is basically you try to simplify. And then you draw inferences. Then you connect those inferences. And then you move to questions. Right? That's the funda that we have discussed in the introduction session also. So let's read properly. Because without reading, you cannot realize whether a set is easy or difficult. Without spending some time on the set, you cannot come to a conclusion whether this set is solvable or not. Okay? Because that also has to be inculcated. Right? Let's see. Funky Pizzeria was required to supply pizzas to 3 different parties. The total number of pizzas it had to deliver was 800. So, important number here. 70% of which were to be delivered to party 3. And the rest equally divided between party 1 and party 2. So, let's stop at this point and let's, you know, infer out of this. So, basically, total number of pizzas, you have 800, right? That's the total. Right? And this 1800 is split into 3 parties, P1, P2 and P3. And what is the bifurcation? 70% of 800 is given to party 3. And if you realize, 70% of 800 is nothing but 560. And the remaining was equally divided. So remaining is 240, which makes it 120 each. Right? So this is the first point of inference that you draw from the first line. 560, 120 and 120. Right? Okay. I'm pretty sure that most of you would have done this, but let's see. Now, pizzas could be of thin crust or deep dish. Let's stop at this point, okay? Pizzas could be of thin crust or deep dish. So basically, all these 800 will either be of thin crust category or deep dish. Thin crust or deep dish, right? Fine. Now, and come in either normal cheese or extra cheese version. Now, what does it mean? You have 800 pizzas in total, which have been given to 3 parties, right? These 800 will be either thin crust or deep dish in terms of the crust. And in terms of the amount of cheese, these 800 will either be normal cheese or extra cheese, right? So, because of this structure, hence, there are 4 types of pizzas. So you can have thin crust with normal cheese. You can have thin crust with extra cheese. You can have deep dish with normal cheese. And you can have deep dish with extra cheese. So these are the 4 possible pizza combinations that you can make based on the crust and the type of cheese. Right? This is given very clearly in the question also. Now, partial information about proportions of T and NC pizzas ordered by the 3 parties is given below. So there's a table which is given, but it's a partial table. What is the meaning of a partial table? A partial table will have incomplete information or missing information, right? Fine. So let's see. So basically, I can simplify this story, right? So I can remove all this now. I'll draw a rough table here, okay? Thin crust, deep dish, normal cheese, extra cheese, right? So this is called simplification. You try to simplify your data using some kind of representation or some kind of notes. I'm using a diagram here, right? And I have got 3 parties. P1, P2 and P3, right? Now, the table which is given is a partial table. What we have drawn on the right hand side is a complete table. That has to be the goal, right? To fill in the missing void. Now let's see what they have given. Let's try to understand the numbers inside the table, because if you cannot understand the numbers inside the table, what do they represent? You cannot move on with the set. Okay, fine. So let's try to understand. Now, this is what I mean by subset analysis. Whenever you have to understand something out of a particular data diagram, you just pick one element out of it. So let's say I just want to understand this part. I just am focusing on this subset. So this says that the proportion. What do these numbers represent as per the question? It says partial information about proportions of T and NC pizzas offered by 3 parties are given, right? So if you see, I know all pizzas will be either thin crust or deep dish. in terms of the crust, right? And it says that of the party one pizzas, 0.6. What is the meaning of 0.6? It can be called 60% also. Yes or no? 0.6 can be called 60%, right? 0.6 is nothing but 6 by 10. And what is 6 by 10? 60%, right? So it says that 0.6 of party one, pizzas delivered to party one, they are of thin crust variety. So basically, if you see, I'm going to now input some data into our table. I know that party one, if it is 0.6, right? Thin crust pizzas, they correspond to this 0.6. So it automatically means that deep dish would be 0.4, 40%. Yes or no? Are we understanding this part here? If thin crust corresponds to 0.6, deep dish has to correspond to 0.4, right? Now, if you understand this part, we can quickly fill the table like this, right? Again, for party one, we don't have the data about normal cheese. So we'll keep it as it is. Okay. For party two, thin crust corresponds to 0.55. So the pizza has to be either TC or DD. So this would mean 0.45. Here, for party two, the cheese is 0.3. Normal cheese category, right? So extra cheese category has to be 0.7 for party two, right? For party three, we don't have the information about thin crust. So we cannot, for now, we cannot comment on deep dish, but we very well can comment on this cheese category, right? 0.65 is normal cheese category, which means that 0.35 is extra cheese category, right? So this is your first level of inference. What we have done right now is first level of inference. Okay, very basic inferences. Most of you should be able to do it, but this is called first level of inference. Okay, I am going step by step, very slow for the first few sets so that you understand the process. So, thoda dhyan se sunna. Okay, even if you have been able to solve the set, you may learn out of the process here. Okay, fine. So, whatever I have written in red right now is called first level of inference. Now, we already had decoded that party three. Total number of pizzas given to party 3 was 560, party 2 was 120, and party 1 was 120. Ye humne pehle se hi nikal ke rakha tha, right? Fine. Now, there's one more information given, which is regards to total. So let's write total here. Total is 0.375. Total is 0.375. Now, I know total is 800. I know total is 800. So I have to figure out 0.375 of 800 that will correspond to thin crust pizzas. Now, if you see, if I ask you what is the value of 1 by 8 in terms of decimals or in terms of percentage, what is 1 by 8? 12.5%, right? So in terms of decimal, it is 0.125. So in terms of decimals, it would be 0.125, right? So what is this 0.375? You should be able to quickly figure out that 0.375 is nothing but 3 by 8. 0.375 is nothing but 3 by 8. And what is 3 by 8 of 800? 300. So total number of thin crust pizzas were 300, which makes total number of deep dish pizzas to be 500. Right? Are we okay with this inference? 3 by 8 and 5 by 8. Right? A basic idea of percentage will enable you to do this. Nothing very challenging. Right? Fine. Now let's try to fill the other parts of the table. Okay? Now if you see, this normal cheese is also given. Right? Now let's not get the numbers for now, but I know that normal cheese, the proportion is 0.52. So extra cheese, the proportion would be 0.48. This is for total, right? If you want to find out, you can find out very fast, and I'll show you a better method of doing so. But thoda dekho yahan pe dhyan se. So I've just written whatever is given. Now there's nothing that I can extract out of the given set, right? Whatever was needed, we have it in our diagram. Now I don't have to go back to my set and read something again. I haven't missed out on any condition. This is a trait of an easy set. Whenever you're able to quickly put down the data, whenever you're able to quickly simplify the data, it's a good indicator that the set is easy, at least in terms of interpretation of the given conditions. If you remember the first introductory session, I had discussed about two kinds of conditions, right? Given conditions and additional conditions. Where are additional conditions present? They can be present in the question. They can be present in the question. Samajh mein aa raha hai acche se yahan pe? So what are we working on? So all this is called given condition. and we have translated given conditions into a table on the right hand side, right? I don't have to read any of the given condition lines again because we have written everything. Fine. So let's now work on our table. Okay. So this red is your basic level of inference. Now we have to go deep into it and understand other parts, right? Now I know P1 is 120 and I know thin crust is 0.6 of 120. Now what is 0.6 of 120? Very easy. 72, which makes 0.4 of 120, 48, right? So in black, I'm writing down the actual number of pizzas, right? If I go to this P2 now, I know P2 is also 120, but if you see this P2 will either be of thin crust variety or deep dish variety. And the proportion is this, right? 55 is to 45. So rather than working on this 55 is to 45, can I do this? Can I simplify this? And this can be done mentally. Okay. I'm doing it because you can see it. It's 11 is to 9. Dikhe aa raha sabko yahan pe? So can I say 11 parts plus 9 parts, which is equal to 20 parts. This 20 parts correspond to 120. That is the total number of pizzas of P2, right? So what is the correspondence here? The correspondence is 6. So basically for 11, I want 66. For 9, I want 54. And I can write 66 and 54 here, right? One way of doing this is you figure out 55% of 120 and 45% of 120. I think this is a faster way because the numbers are more convenient here. Depending on your calculation speed, you can do this. Okay. Sabko ye process samajh mein aa raha maine kya kiya yahan pe? And fine. So similarly, I can go about others also. If you see, we have realized, focus on this row, thin crust row. I know the total of this, focus on this column, sorry, thin crust column. Total is going to be 300. I know this is 72. I know this is 66. Can I figure out this? It's going to be 300 minus 72 minus 66, right? 72 plus 66 is 138. So 300 minus 138 is nothing but 162. Ye maine bhar diya yahan pe, right? Similarly, I can figure out this part. 48 plus 54. 48 plus 54 is 102. If I subtract 500 from it, I mean 500 minus 102, I'll get 398. Right? Now moving to NCEC bracket. But let's first figure out what we already have. That is the red numbers. So 0.3 out of 120, right? So it's going to be 36. And 120 minus 36 is nothing but 84. Right? Now let's figure out this. So again, I have to break 560 into this ratio. 65 is to 35. I can quickly do it. 5 goes 13 times, 5 goes 7 times. So 13 and 7. So I know 13 plus 7 is 20. 20 parts correspond to 560. So the correspondence is 28. One part will correspond to 28. And what I need is, I need 13 and 7. Right? So 13 will correspond to 13 into 28 and 7 will correspond to 7 into 28. Of these two, the smaller number is 7 into 20. I'll work on this. How can I work on this really fast? I can break this 28 into 7 into 4. And this is nothing but 49 into 4. 49 into 4 is nothing but 196. Right? So basically, this is 196. So this 0.65 in this NC column will correspond to 560 minus 196, which is going to be 364. Right? Now, because we have got this number also, we can really find this number very fast. So 364 plus 36, right? Abhi thoda dhyan se dekho. I know total number of pizzas is 800 and I have to find these two numbers. So 800 has to be broken in the ratio 52 is to 48. What is 52 is to 48? 13 is to 12. So again, 13 plus 12 is 25. 25 parts correspond to 800. If 25 parts correspond to 800, one part will correspond to 800 by 25, which if you calculate, it will be equal to 32, right? So basically, this 13 part will correspond to 13 into 32 and 12 part will correspond to 12 into 32, right? 32 into 13 is nothing but 320 plus 96, which is equal to 416. If this is 416, this has to be 800 minus 416, which is going to be 384. Right now I can figure out P1 NC and P1 EC. How come? A total is 416. 364 plus 36 is equal to 400. 416 minus 400 is equal to 16. So this is going to be 16. right? Similarly, for the EC column, what you can do is 196 plus 84. 196 plus 84 is nothing but 280. So 384 minus 280 is nothing but 104. Now, if you see, the table is complete. So till now, if I want to break this up, basically the red is your first level of inference. Black is your second level of inference, which you got after doing some calculations, some very basic calculations. Are we understanding this part here? So as of this moment, if I have to make a flow chart, what have we done? We have read well, then we have simplified the data in the form of a table. Then what we have done, we have drawn red inferences. Then we have converted those red inferences to black inferences, and the table is complete. So at this point, simplification is done. So this is a good indicator that I have to move to questions. I cannot take any other help from the given conditions, right? So you have to make a habit out of this, okay? Because this is an easy set, it's easier to visualize this flowchart, okay? Fine. Now we have to go to the questions, right? Now, if you carefully observe, see the first question, okay? We are not interested in the answer for now, but see the first question. How many thin crust pizzas? Second question, how many normal cheese pizzas? Third question, for party to if. Fourth question, suppose. So you should understand that one and two are those questions which can be solved on the given conditions. Basically, and three and four are those questions which need some additional or new conditions. And if it needs some additional or new conditions, it will be furnished in the question. And what are the signal words for it? If, suppose. So whenever you find these two words, if or suppose, right, it shows that there's going to be an additional condition. So basically, in a time-constrained environment, if I have to choose two out of four questions, what should be those two questions? It has to be one and two. Three and four, mein solve karunga because it is going to take slightly more time because they are conditional questions. I hope you are realizing this point here. Sabko samajh mein aa raha hai acche se yahan pe? So basically, it's a good indicator for you to identify conditional questions. Okay, fine. Now, let's first figure out one and two. Because many a times you have to realize that it's not feasible to solve all questions within a particular set. You can always pick up easy questions within a particular set and you can give time to the other set in a time-constrained environment. But right now, because we are learning, we'll be solving anything and everything, right? But we also have to realize what can be solved in an exam hall and what cannot be solved in an exam hall. That we'll be doing after completion of one particular set. So let's see the questions now. Fine. So first question. I know first and two are going to be straightforward, straight out of our table. Let's see. How many thin crust pizzas were to be delivered to party three? So thin crust and party three. So thin crust and party three. So answer is going to be 162. Very straightforward, right? Second, how many normal cheese pizzas were required to be delivered at party one? So normal cheese and party one. Answer has to be 16. Right? Question number three. I know question number three is going to be a conditional question, right? So thoda dhyan se padhenge because an additional condition is going to be there and that is important to solve the question. Without that, you may not be able to solve the question. Let's read now properly. If, again, the same process starts, you have to now make inferences because there's an additional condition. If 50% of the normal cheese pizza were of thin crust variety. Okay, fine. So let's first focus on the normal cheese pizza. Okay, for party two, right? So what is your highlight area right now? Party two. This is the area that you have to restrict yourself on, right? Because the entire question is on party two. So aur kuch mujhe table mein dikhna hi nahi chahiye. This is my highlighted area, right? Fine. So if you see 50% of normal cheese pizzas, right? For party two. So we're looking at this number, right? 36. Okay. So it says that if 50% of normal cheese pizzas were of thin crust variety, so which pizza are we talking about? Thin crust with normal cheese. Thin crust with normal cheese. It says 50%, matlab 50% of 36 is 18. Right? Question number three is about party two, right? So we know that 18 is of this type, thin crust plus normal cheese, right? Let's figure out all the other varieties of pizzas. What are the other varieties which can be possible? Thin crust plus extra cheese, deep dish plus extra cheese, deep dish plus normal cheese, right? Regardless of the question, let's figure out everything here. Okay, fine. So thin crust plus extra cheese. Let's see. Abhi dekho, normal cheese 18 hai, and that normal cheese belongs to thin crust category. So the remaining of normal cheese has to belong to deep dish category. So deep dish plus normal cheese would also be 18. I hope you're understanding this part, because pizza ya to normal cheese hoga ya to extra cheese hoga. And I know 50% of normal cheese is of thin crust variety. So the remaining 50% has to be of deep dish variety, right? Now, if you proceed here, thin crust plus extra cheese. Abhi maine bola 50%, matlab 18 is thin crust plus normal cheese. Now read it this way. 18 of thin crust is normal cheese. We're reading it in a different way right now. 18 of thin crust is normal cheese. And total we have 66 thin crust, right? So remaining of thin crust have to be of extra cheese. So which has to be 66 minus 18? Which has to be 48. Right? Samajh mein aa raha hai acche se yahan pe? Now if you see, 48 of extra cheese belongs to thin crust. 48 of extra cheese belongs to thin crust. So remaining of extra cheese has to belong to deep dish. And total extra cheese is 84. So 84 minus 48 is 36. I hope you are realizing what we have done here, because even the fourth question is on the same format. Are we okay with three? How to read it? Fine. So now let's see the question. What was the difference between the number of TEC and DEC? So we're looking at thin crust extra cheese, which is this, and deep dish extra cheese, which is this. And you have to find the difference. So 48 minus 36, what is the answer? The answer is 12, right? Let's see question number four. Now, whenever you have a conditional question, never erase the rough work. That rough work may come handy in any of the other questions. Your rough work always has to be tidy. Rough work hamesha bacha ke rakhna, because you never know which rough work for which particular question can help you in some other question. But if you, you know, remove it, or if you ignore it, or if you have moved to the other page, that's a big problem. That's why it's always recommended when you're doing rough work for a particular DI set, it has to be on one page. Basically, all of it has to be visible on the same page. I hope you guys are realizing this very important point, and you will witness it because of the fourth question. Because if in case you change your page of rough work, you'll have to go back to the previous page, and that becomes a problem while solving LRDI sets, specifically for very, very cluttered database sets, when you need to extract a lot out of every particular statement. This is still a very easy set compared to the kind of sets which were there in last paper. Anyways, let's see the next question. I know it's going to be a conditional question, right? So I haven't removed my data here. Okay, it's still the same. Fine. Suppose, so again, there's an if. Suppose means an if, right? What are you asking me to repeat? Rough work point. So what I'm saying is, always keep your rough work organized. Okay, third one again. Oh, okay, fine. So see, try to listen this in one go, because anyways you'll be having the recording to rewatch it, but try to listen this in one go. Maine bahut hi slowly dhyan se bataya tha. It's a matter of lack of concentration here. Read this statement. If 50% of normal cheese pizzas were of thin crust, we are talking about party two. Okay. This is for those students who have asked me to repeat. So the answer suno, please. For party two. So party two, I've already highlighted, right? In party two, normal cheese pe dhyan do. Normal cheese ke kitne pizza hai in party two? Tell me. Tell me. Those who have asked me to repeat. Normal cheese, party two, how many pizzas are there? 36, right? What is 50% of 36? What is 50% of 36? 18. So what is 18 as per the question? 18 belongs to normal cheese and thin crust. Yes or no? 18 belongs to normal cheese and thin crust. Yahan tak clear hai? Right. If 18 belongs to normal cheese and thin crust, acha batao mujhe abhi. फॉर पार्टी टू नॉर्मल चीज के 36 पिज्जाज है जिसमें से 18 थिन क्रस्ट के होंगे, तो बाकी 18 कहां जाएंगे? तो बाकी 18 कहां जाएंगे? नॉर्मल चीज के 18 अगर थिन क्रस्ट है तो बाकी 18 कहां जाएंगे आउट ऑफ 36? डीप डिश. सो इवन दिस इज क्लियर, राइट? नाउ यू टेल मी, अगर फोकस ऑन दिस नाउ, ओके, फोकस ऑन द पार्ट विच यू हैव येलोड आउट राइट नाउ, ओके, थिन क्रस्ट पे फोकस करते हैं. मुझे पता है एज ऑफ नाउ 18 हैव गॉन टू थिन क्रस्ट, 18 हैव गॉन टू थिन क्रस्ट. So out of 66, I know that 18 are of normal cheese, right? So baki ke jo thin crust pizza honge, wo kaha jayenge? Extra cheese mein. So if you remove 18 out of 66, that is 48. 48 will belong to what? Thin crust plus extra cheese. Are you okay with this? Right? Similarly, if I know that 18, now see this, 48 is thin crust, extra cheese, right? So out of 84 extra cheese, you have taken out 48. Out of 84 extra cheese, you have taken out 48. Aur ye extra cheese wale thin crust mein gaye, to baki bache kahan jayenge? Baki bache extra cheese wale kahan jayenge? Deep dish mein. And wo kitne honge? 84 minus 48, which is equal to 36. I hope it's clear now. Are you okay? Can I move on? Okay. Coming to the fourth question now. Now, fourth question, as I've told you, keep your rough work always and always visible to you. So for that purpose, you have to make sure that your entire rough work for one particular set is on one page. Okay, fine. Suppose, means a conditional question, let's read the condition. Suppose if a TNC pizza, thin crust normal cheese pizza, costs as much as a DNC pizza. So let's, you know, write this down. TNC, the cost is given as same as DNC. But 3/5 of the pizza of a DEC, but this is equal to 3/5 the price of a DEC. Right? Okay. Aage padhte hain. A DEC pizza costs 50 more than TEC pizza. One more information is here. DEC costs 50 more than TEC. And the latter costs 500. What is the meaning of latter here? Is it DEC or TEC? What is the meaning of latter? TEC, right? Right. So basically, TEC I know. So they have given you one fixed information here. That this TEC is nothing but 500. The cost of one TEC pizza is what? 500, right? So if TEC is 500, I know DEC. DEC is 550. And if DEC is 550, 3 by 5 or 550 is 330. So DNC is 330 and TNC is also 330. So sare pizza ke cost aapko pata hai yahan pe. For the fourth question's condition, right? Now let's read on. Now the condition is given. Now fourth takes the same form as that of the third question. Throw the answer, dekho, okay? Fine. I'm solving fourth here, okay? I know there are going to be four kinds of pizza, right? TC, EC, DDEC, and DDNC. Now, if 25% of normal cheese pizza delivered to party one, so now here your highlight area becomes party one. Like in question number three, your highlight area was party two. Now your highlight area becomes party one. This is your highlight area, blue one. क्या आ रहा है सबको यहां पे? राइट, सो लेट्स फिगर आउट व्हाट कैन वी डू नेक्स्ट ईयर. फाइन, 25%. आई होप यू गाइस कैन सी द टेबल, राइट? टेबल दिख रहा है ना सबको? द टेबल विच वी हैव क्रिएटेड. फाइन फाइन फाइन, ठीक है. 25% ऑफ नॉर्मल चीज पिज्जा डिलीवर्ड टू पार्टी वन. 25% ऑफ नॉर्मल चीज पिज्जा डिलीवर्ड टू पार्टी वन, राइट? चलो पार्टी वन पे नॉर्मल चीज पिज्जा की बात करते हैं, विच इज दिस 16, राइट? दिस 16, 25% ऑफ 16. व्हाट इज 25% ऑफ 16? 4. एंड दिस 4 वर ऑफ डीप डिश वैरायटी. 4 वर ऑफ डीप डिश वैरायटी, राइट? सो वी हैव गॉट डीप डिश एंड नॉर्मल चीज विच इज इक्वल टू 4. ये पॉइंट क्लियर है? वी आर डूइंग द एग्जैक्ट सेम ड्रिल दैट वी डिड फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. सो डीप डिश नॉर्मल चीज आ गया 4. नाउ लेट्स फिगर आउट एवरी अदर वेराइटी कितने होंगे. सो एक बात बताओ, अगर नॉर्मल चीज 16 है टोटल, उसमें से 4 इज ऑफ डीप डिश वेराइटी, सो बाकी के नॉर्मल चीज क्या होंगे? थिन क्रस्ट. सो इफ यू रिमूव 4 आउट ऑफ 16, वॉट इज रिमेनिंग? 12. ये बात समझ में आ गई. नाउ लेट्स कनेक्ट दी डॉट्स. थिन क्रस्ट की बात करते हैं. P1 में थिन क्रस्ट टोटल 72 है. आउट ऑफ 72, 12 हैज गॉन टू नॉन चीज. सो रिमेनिंग 60 हैज टू गो टू एक्स्ट्रा चीज. राइट, नाउ यू अगेन गो टू एक्स्ट्रा चीज. इफ एक्स्ट्रा चीज इज 104 फॉर P1, ऑफ विच 60 इज ऑफ थिन क्रस्ट वेराइटी, सो द रिमेनिंग 44 हैज टू बी ऑफ डीप डिश वेराइटी. आर वी ओके विद दिस? एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग दैट वी डिड फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 हियर. But 4 had an additional condition in terms of the cost of the pizza. Samajh mein aa raha hai ye baat? So here what you can learn is how to make a question lengthy. Question number 3 and question number 4 are exactly on the same concept, right? But they have created a lengthy question out of question number 4 by adding an additional constraint of cost. I hope you're realizing this part here. See, you learn a lot more things from easy questions compared to difficult questions. Fine. Abhi dekho, thoda. अभी ये पार्ट हो गया. नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन, राइट? दैट शुड नॉट बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. लेट्स सी, व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? व्हाट वाज द टोटल बिल फॉर पार्टी वन? व्हाट वाज द टोटल बिल फॉर पार्टी वन? राइट, मेरे पास कॉस्ट ऑलरेडी पता है. सो ये थिन क्रस्ट प्लस नॉर्मल चीज का कॉस्ट कितना है एज पर आर इन्फ्रेंस हमने जो निकाला है? देखो, व्हाट इज द कॉस्ट फॉर थिन क्रस्ट प्लस नॉर्मल चीज? 330. सो 12 इंटू 330. थिन क्रस्ट प्लस एक्स्ट्रा चीज, व्हाट इज थिन क्रस्ट प्लस एक्स्ट्रा चीज? 500. सो इंटू 500. DD plus extra cheese, what is DD plus extra cheese? 550. So this into 550. DD plus NC, 330. So this complete addition is going to be the total cost, right? Now what smartly you can do here is, because you have options here, first of all, main sare mein se ek zero hata do. So sare options mein se ek zero hata sakta hu main? Yes or no? Because all the options are ending in zero. Ye baat samajh mein aa rahi hai acche se? Are you guys realizing what I'm doing here? There's no need to actually get the answer here. So if you see 33 into 12 plus 50 into 60 plus 55 into 44 plus 33 into 4. Now if you see all the options, okay, I'll just figure out the unit digit of this. Mujhe kya nikalna hai? Sirf unit digit. Pehla try kya karunga main? I'll try to figure out the unit digit. Finding unit digit is very easy. I just have to focus on the unit digit. Now tell me what is going to be the unit digit for this. 3 into 2, 6. यहां पे 0. 5 into 4, 0. 3 into 4, 12. 12 cut 2. What is going to be the unit digit for this entire result? 8. There's only one option which has 8 here. That is going to be the answer. The answer is going to be 59480. So there's no need to actually multiply and get the answer. You can actually be smart about it. समझ में आ रहा अच्छे से हमने मैंने क्या किया यहाँ पे? And this finding this unit digit cannot take more than 2 to 3 seconds. Are we okay with this complete question? So if you realize what have we done here, we started off with reading. So again, I'll draw a simple flow chart here. Okay. And I'm telling you, this was one of the easier sets of the paper. Okay. So again, this is important. More exposure, you'll feel good about LRDI. बट अगर घबराना शुरू कर दोगे अभी से ही बहुत प्रॉब्लम होने वाली है. इट्स वेरी सिमिलर टू सॉल्विंग अ सुडोकू. पहले दिन सॉल्व करने बैठा, सॉल्व नहीं हुआ, डीमोटिवेट होकर रोना धोना शुरू करोगे, कुछ नहीं होगा. ठीक है, फाइन. सो टेल मी द फ्लो चार्ट. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी रेड, देन एज पर द कलर सिंबल्स दैट आई हैव यूज्ड हियर. पहले हमने क्या किया? पढ़ा. पढ़ने के बाद हमने क्या किया? टेबल बनाया. राइट, टेबल वॉज अ पार्ट ऑफ सिंप्लीफिकेशन. आई वॉज एबल टू मेक अ टेबल. एंड आफ्टर दैट वी मेड रेड इन्फ्रेंसेज, विच वर वेरी इजी टू मेक. क्विक इन्फ्रेंसेज वर रेड इन्फ्रेंसेज. Then some calculation based inferences were your black inferences, right? After that, the table was complete. Then we moved to questions. We realized there are two varieties of questions, one with given conditions, two with given conditions, and two with additional conditions. We will solve given conditions question first, because there you don't need to do anything extra. You can just use your table to get the answer. So first we solved all the given condition questions. Then we moved to additional condition questions. In this, whenever you solve one additional condition question in CAT, there's a very high probability that it may be connected to the other question. For example, in this, if you see, third question was very similar to the fourth question. So if you figure out the solution for 3, 4 is also same. So keep your rough ID. मतलब मुझे ये बार बार लिखने की जरूरत नहीं चाहिए. जब एग्जाम में सॉल्व करोगे ना, यहाँ पे इक्वल टू लाल के इस साइड भी सॉल्व कर सकते हो ना. TC plus NC for fourth question, TC plus EC for fourth question, DV plus EC for fourth question, DD plus NC for fourth question. There's no need to write this all over again. समझ में आ रहा अच्छे से? You have to save time on all that part. Do not do any physical labor. And make sure that your rough work is always visible on one single sheet of paper. There's no need to turn back pages. Right? And if you see, third and fourth question are very similar. And whenever a calculation-based question is there, always apply smart techniques. Like first figure out the unit digit. There might be a possibility that you may not have to calculate the entire thing. I hope this entire discussion is clear for this question. Are we okay? Right. So whenever you're going to solve this question again while revising, just make sure that you do not see the solution. You have to do it on your own. Theek hai? Fine. Let's go to the second question. Chalega? Same drill. I'll give you some time to read, think, solve. I'll tell you when to stop. You'll stop at that point of time and then we'll discuss. Okay. Just give me a second. Okay. I'll take you to the question.